Alliance, which is presenting this concert today. We're an RSO that supports composers, the entrepreneurship of composers, and just general music makers in our WMU community. So this concert is one of the things that we do, but the other big thing is we bring in guest artists every year using different funding from Student Association and various sponsorships. And I would go into a long spiel about all the events we have coming up, but instead, I'm going to say go to our Experience WMU page, which I updated to include all the dates of upcoming guest artists and whatnot. So, if you know what Experience WMU is, that's where you can find everything. Hope you enjoy the concert. Let's welcome Kyle Bollinger to the stage.
But then one night we were a couple libations deep, I must have said something like silly or self-deprecating or something. She just looks over me at me and smiles and she goes, "Oh, Kyle." And I was like, "I get it, I understand that." So anyway, you'll probably hear that. The song is called "I Want You." Also, hi mom. here we go.
Yeah. my name is Jonah Y. I'm a member of the WSCA, and what you're about to hear is a song that I wrote called What Could Have Been. It is a part of an EP that I put out on all streaming platforms last September under the same name, What Could Have Been. This song is my attempt at doing a sort of like singer-songwriter acoustic guitar driven track, and I challenged myself by making it so, as opposed to my typical workflow of using electronics and MIDI instruments, I made it so I could only use live-recorded real instruments, and I had to play everything myself. And if you don't know me, I play this many instruments. So it was a struggle. But I found ways to work with instruments in ways that are maybe unconventional. I came up with a custom tuning for my acoustic guitar to make it look like I knew what I was doing. And it turned out pretty cool. So I hope you guys enjoy. Fair warning, there is one small use of explicit language, so if that's not your vibe, I'm sorry. Enjoy.
Thank you.
song in August. I'm just calling it Sunset now, rather than Let the Sunset Know. It just feels a little wordy and mouthful. It's kind of been evolving since then, but I just finished the words quite recently. So I'm quite excited to play it for you all with a little something like this. As I drove away from you last night, I wondered why we had to part. You said that you had someone in your life, darling, you're on my mind, not near or far. There's something that I've learned from life, and watching the sun die every night. It's loving you and letting you go your own way home. Do you want my love for you? I kind of think you do. Well, the sunset knows it shows to you again.
Start the year fresh. And This song is kind of really personal for me, and I actually kind of wanted to share a bit about it. I thought this would be the right crowd. You know, as young musicians, I think we all kind of can relate to the experience of getting together with friends and talking about, you know, reaching the top of that mountain that we're all wishing to hit. And, you know, I certainly did that in high school. And I had a friend of mine who actually kind of seemed like they hit that escape velocity and actually got there. And I was sitting in a math class in 11th grade dreaming about touring Europe, and she actually was touring Europe. And I wish I could say that I was like proud and like happy, but unfortunately I was just really envious. And it kind of really burned me up. And then I came to college and found out like all these people that I would meet knew her, like, and listened to her music, and it just became this like thing where I was like, oh man, you know, it was just this obsession with being envious and kind of like a jealous person about it. And then I wrote this song sophomore year because I kind of decided that I was being really ridiculous and kind of wanted to write something a little sarcastic, but also a little genuine about kind of the way that proximity to fame and, you know, envy and jealousy can kind of get to you and affect you. So, thank you. I hope you enjoy.
I wish I was you. to Rotay. These are my incredible, beautiful, wonderful performers. And today we are going to sing a piece for you called Stratospheric. This piece is about a healing journey and the sort of self-transformation that takes place from a place of mourning to a place of joy, and really just celebrating how far you've come in your authenticity. And then it was inspired by a poem I wrote that I'm going to quickly read to you, because those are the lyrics of the piece. Freedom, a journey of heartbreak and yearning. For the tables are turning away. Why is kindness a burden? We won't fall to the current. For love is certain to save the words we've been longing to say. If you could see me now, I found my way somehow into the blue sky.
For the tables are turning. thinking that I'm doing this poorly thus far.
Oh, there we go.
Yay. And I'm just kind of vamping right now. I want to make sure that everything does in fact work, such as the nature of electroacoustic music. And you're probably wondering why I decided to put the music directly in front of me. And for that, I respond, have you seen The Wizard of Oz? Believe you me, we'll see enough of me on the screen before the piece is done. But yes, anyway, this is my piece, internal monologue with a captive audience. It is a piece written somewhat personally. I am turning up the master volume on my amp. And I will be 6 years clean and sober in April, and I wanted to write this piece. We live in kind of a world where we pride the idea of getting in touch with ourselves and sort of listening to our heart and following our heart, and I believe that that is a good thing, and my heart tries to tell me devilish things that sort of undo all the wonderful things I have in my life. And so in that, I sort of live in this opposition to myself, and so I wrote this piece to sort of go through what that split sense of self is like to experience. So anyway, thank you very much. it may,